What is going on, everyone? Today I'm gonna do a full day of high carb eating. So I've been low carb for the past 3 days because, guys, I'm not gonna lie to you. When I was in China, I ate like a pig. I ate tons of Chinese food. I gained probably around 5 pounds, which is not good because I have a photo shoot in about a month. I started off the week great in China, but then, like, I don't know, the second day, it just fell apart. So I would eat clean throughout the day, and then at night I would have like a huge meal with everyone, because when I was in China, I wanted to enjoy Chinese food, and that's what I did. So today is that fourth day. So I went 3 days pretty much no carbs, just besides vegetables. And today is gonna be a high carb day. I'm not really sure how many carbs I'm gonna eat today. I'll figure it up later on today. But right now, we're gonna start off with breakfast. So I'm gonna have, I just got done cooking a cup of oatmeal. And there it is. And then I'm gonna add a scoop of whey protein. This is the Platinum Whey Muscle Tech Vanilla Cake. And Santi and Nikki told me that this is an amazing combination, adding it to your oatmeal. So I've been doing it and it tastes so good. And then I'm gonna have half a cup of egg whites that I'm gonna cook here in a second. The supplements I'm taking today is the exact same supplements that I showed you in the low carb. I'm gonna have the omega-3s, clear muscle, 2 tablets, CLA, and a multivitamin, the VitaMax. And that's all what these are right here. And then I keep them in this pill container so I don't have to pull out every single one of these every time. So I'm gonna get done with all this cooking. I gotta cook the egg whites and then have my morning coffee. So this morning I woke up and did 45 minutes of cardio and then just some calves, just to get up and burn some calories. Catching up to do since my last video, which was coming home from China. So Shelby made it home from her business trip from Minnesota. I think it was Minnesota. I can't honestly remember. And then this weekend, I got my hand stuck. We are going back home to Memphis to see family for Easter. So we're driving out Wednesday. Today is Monday. So we're gonna drive out Wednesday, see them, and then we're gonna come back next Monday, because the next weekend I'm going to an expo with bodybuilding.com. So it's gonna be a very fast trip back to Memphis. We have to drive because we have to take Gainer. So that's gonna be, you know, that 12 hour drive, 11 hours. So that's gonna suck so bad just to come straight back in like 4 days. But we gotta do what we gotta do. And then today I am discussing my renewal contract with Muscle Tech. This is always like the dreaded thing with companies and getting contracts, getting sponsored. They go by year. So every single year you have to renegotiate your contract. And that is going on this week. I already talked to him once last week. We went over some emails and stuff, and then we're gonna talk on the phone later on today to finalize the contract. And I have nothing but good to say about Muscle Tech. This has been the greatest company I've been with, besides bodybuilding.com. They're one of the same, meaning that they're so easy to work with. Everything they say they're going to do, they do plus more. So this was a big blessing to get Muscle Tech this year, because all the other supplement companies that I have been with honestly have not been great to work with, but Muscle Tech has done everything and above more to make me happy. And you know, I'm growing at the same time they're growing, so I'm helping their company out as well, and they see that. So it's been great. So I am going over that today, and then I have to do a video for a campaign that they're doing. It's called Why I Lift, and one of their athletes, Fabian, I have to do a reaction video to his video. And I've never done a reaction video, and I have to do that today on that video. And they're gonna be recording me Later on, I think like in 2 months, I'm going to do the same thing that his video's on, Why I Live campaign. They're going to come to my house, or they're going to go back home to where I used to live in Memphis with all my family and record my day-to-day life, talk to my family, interview my family, and just kind of video exactly how I became a fitness model and how I became a sponsored athlete through Muscle Tech. So looking forward to that, but that's going to be later on. Man, what else is going on? Just the same-o right now. Getting ready to start traveling a lot again, because I had only like maybe a week and a half from China, and then, you know, going back home and then getting back, going to an expo, and then going to FIBO later on next month to Germany. So looking forward to that, but it's a lot going on. So I got done with the video Why I Live thing, and it was just awkward. I got done with the video, and you know, one of those videos, reaction videos, you know, you do them and the videos are like really funny and stuff. The Why I Live campaign is not really funny, so I did the video like Muscle Tech wanted, but I'm not sure how or where they're gonna use it and stuff, so I don't know. I'll be looking for it later, see if they actually use it. Now we're moving on to lunch. I just got done grilling or frying some chicken over here. It is burnt to a crisp because I have to hurry, because in 30 minutes I'm talking to Muscle Tech, so I'm trying to make my lunch as fast as possible, and then I'm just gonna have to down it. So I got the low carb wraps, I got two of those. Both of those together is 30 carbs. So 90 calories per flatbread. So one of these little tortillas is now 90 calories. I got 6 ounces of chicken breast. So I'm just gonna distribute those on both of these. I got pickles. I have this classic ranch dressing, yogurt ranch dressing, mustard, and pickles is so good. I don't know why, but pickles and chicken to me on wraps is amazing, I think because of Chick-fil-A. You know, they put pickles on their chicken sandwiches, and it just, it's amazing. So I'm gonna put some spinach on there as well. And then for chips, Garner, you can eat that. He loves vegetables. He runs over here. Look, spinach. And then for chips, I'm going to have these Pop Chips barbecue, just like a serving of these. And per serving is 120 calories, only 19 carbs and 4 grams of fat and 20 chips. So really good macros on that. So I'm gonna enjoy this and then get on the phone with Muscle Tech. Literally just got off the phone with Muscle Tech just now. I'm so excited to say I'm officially signed with them for another year. So that's 2 years with the best supplement company that I honestly could be with. It has been, like I said, amazing time with them, and I would really honestly say that their supplements are the best supplements I've ever taken in my life. Even when I first got started in the industry, Muscle Tech was actually the very first supplement that I bought. It was a protein powder and a pre-workout, and they were the very first ones. It was actually in a GNC, and I could not be more proud to be with this company for another year. So I'm looking forward to another exciting year with them. Now it's around 2:15. I'm gonna edit some videos, get those all done. I gotta edit a lot of China videos. I am way behind in that, so edit videos. And then we're gonna head to the gym in a little while. Oh, and if you're wondering why there's another mattress behind our couch, is because we bought another mattress for this bed, because while my parents came down to visit maybe around 2 months ago, me and Shelby slept on this couch bed, and oh my gosh, it was just painful to sleep on. Like, we could not sleep. So we bought another one, and that's the old one, and we don't know what we're gonna do with it. Just throw it away. If we lived in a house, we would store it, and then when people came over, we would pull it, that mattress out, put that one on top of that, so that would be just extra support. But when we don't live in a bigger place, you know, I think we need to get rid of it because that thing is ugly. Having my mid-afternoon cup of coffee, prescription coffee. This mug is the coolest mug. We got hit up, or I did. I got caught up in Starbucks coffee. Yesterday when we were shopping for Easter clothes, Starbucks got me. I had to pick up this new flavor. It's a Komodo Dragon blend. And just because it has a Komodo Dragon on it, I was like, okay, I gotta try it. And it's dark roast. And I love dark roast. That's my favorite coffee. Anytime I go anywhere, I'm gonna get a dark roast over like any kind of like medium or anything. I just don't really like the flavor unless it's super dark. But this coffee is excellent. All right, so the third meal, I'm about to have a protein shake because this will be the meal before the gym and Shelby is blaring Judge Judy, her favorite TV show. No, it's fine. So I'm gonna have a scoop and a half of vanilla funnel cake, the NitroTech Whey Gold, my favorite flavor in the protein. Even smells delicious. So I'm gonna have, like I said, a scoop and a half. I got 8 ounces of unsweetened vanilla almond milk with spinach in there. I'm gonna put some, woo! I don't know why I'm coughing. I'm gonna put some ice in there and blend it up, have that, and then we're gonna head to the gym in about, I don't know, whenever Shelby gets ready. She's over there doing some makeup. And then we're gonna head to the gym. I think I'm gonna be working some back today. What are you working, Shelby?
We'll see.
She has no idea.
Probably.
She's thinking legs. I'm doing legs tomorrow at New Fit because I was gonna do legs today, but I think tomorrow is gonna be a leg day, leg workout. So today, I think I'm gonna do a lot of deadlifts. Oh, and then I'm also gonna add some salt because sodium helps with pumps and it tastes really good to me anyways in a protein shake. And then a little bit of cinnamon, or I say a little bit, I use tons of cinnamon. Cinnamon is probably one of my favorite seasonings ever. Look how delicious this thing looks. I already tasted it. I put the right amount of salt in it and it tastes amazing, so I'm gonna have that. I know some of y'all are wondering why I'm not gonna have carbs in this pre-workout meal. That is because we wanna have more carbs later on after the workout because we're kinda thinking about doing some kind of celebration because I'm signing my second year with Muscle Tech. And the camera is actually focusing on Judge Judy's face right there. You guys can't see that, but I can see it in my little screen over here. But anyways, we're wanting to go out to eat tonight, or you know, Shelby's wanting to, but it's really hard to celebrate because what do you do when you go out and celebrate? You either go out to eat or you go out and drink, and I can't do either one of those. And so we don't know what to do. I was thinking about doing the low carb pizza again, the one that y'all saw in a couple of vlogs back, or having some low fat hamburgers. I'm not sure yet, or we might go out to eat. I don't know. We went out to eat last night and had like a big salad at the Cheesecake Factory, which was very good and huge salad, by the way. It better be because it was like a $20 salad, but I don't know if I wanna eat another salad, you know, because I wanna eat some higher carbs, but I can't go out there and eat like a normal burger or a pizza.
Switching, I got ADD. Brain scatters when you play the beat. It don't matter what you say to me. I'll be doing this at 83. I've been doing this since ABCs in the major leagues, doing major things. Don't play with me. Woo! I'm living life in the fast lane. Wake up every morning thinking I might have a bad day. Drive my own car, I don't like the valet. Park, then I go into my mind with an AK. Shoot every thought in my head, then it rotates. Losing it all, but I think that I'm okay. Who was involved? I don't know, but I'm insane. Who said I'm gone when they call me a no name? I'm probably not what you thought. I'm probably not what you thought. I used to judge everybody that wasn't like me till I learned it was wrong. Girl told me I should get it together and get out the dark. I'm trying to give her my heart. That's when I sit in my car, writing for hours until I can barely talk.
Oh What is going on, everyone? It has been a while since I've done a commentary, so I decided this video was going to be one. And a lot of people like the commentaries because I'm able to explain a little bit more about the workouts and give you some tips and pointers. So we started off the workout with the superset. Normally when I do workouts, I don't start off with the superset, but I was feeling a good superset to start it off with. So we started off with barbell bent over rows. We did 5 sets of 10 reps with the rows and then went into weighted pull-ups, wide grip pull-ups. I did right around like 10 to 12 reps on the pull-ups as well. I have a 45-pound plate that I'm pulling up, you can't see. But like I said, I did 5 sets of those. Now I did on the last set go a good bit heavier. So this is the last set and I might have only got like maybe 6 reps of the bent over rows. And then on the pull-ups, I think I still got around that 10 to 12 reps. This was exhausting because doing a superset with compound movements like the bent over row is just taxing on your body. So I'm just huffing and puffing throughout this exercise, and I'm resting a little bit longer than what I normally do because of it's such a big, you know, muscle group, and I'm doing big superset. So I rested for around, I would say, 2 minutes in between these sets. Other times I'm only resting for around 60 to 90 seconds max on any other, you know, exercises and stuff, but because this was such a hard superset, I let my body rest a little bit longer so that I'm able to, on the next set, get all the reps. Because if I only rested for around 60 to 90 seconds on this superset, I probably would have dropped the reps by half because my body wouldn't have fully recovered. After that superset, went on to dumbbell bent over rows, just single arm. I think what I got here maybe is the 120 or 130 pound dumbbell. I did 4 sets of just 12 reps on each arm. So as you can tell, or as you can see, I'm keeping my lower body completely still, so locked in, and I'm stretching down, letting the dumbbell stretch, and then pulling back my elbows as far back as possible, all under control. During this movement, too many people I see don't go far enough back with their dumbbell rows. They go up, but their elbow doesn't go really past their body. So when you're doing a dumbbell row, I really want you to focus on bringing that elbow back. After that, went on to landmine rows with the row machine. So just to the side, this was actually, I think, the first or second time I've actually done this exercise, and it felt really good. I did 4 sets of around 12 reps on each arm. So, you know, the hand placement is different than doing like a dumbbell row because, you know, when you do a dumbbell row, you're in a neutral grip. So this one, your hands are flat. And you're doing this, and it really felt really good on my mid back. So I'm doing the exact same thing I was doing with the dumbbell rows, going down, stretching, then pulling up, bringing my elbows back. So after doing all those rows, then we went on to pull down. So I really like this cable machine because it's really wide and you're able to bring your arms in and just really squeeze those lats at the bottom. When I'm doing like wide grip pull down, I really can't get that squeeze all the way down because of the bar. But with these two handles being really wide out, you're able to go down and squeeze. So I did 4 sets of 12 reps of those, and then after that went on to close grip pull downs. This just really trying to focus on keeping that muscle contracted the whole time. So going up, stretching up, squeezing, and then pulling down. And this was actually a superset as well. Going for around 12 to 15 reps, superset with low cable pulls for around, I think, maybe 8 to 10. So not many, because after doing the pull downs, I'm exhausted. So did that for 4 sets. And then on to the last exercise. Let's see what it was. I can't even remember here. The last exercise was, okay, rack pull. So this is just to finish off the back workout. I worked my way up in weight. So I started off with 315. I did for around 10 reps, and then I ended up with the 405 and did another 3 sets. So a total of 4 sets of the rack pulls, going for around 10 reps on every single set. And that was the end of the back workout. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Yeah. So done with that workout, and now we're at the grocery store, and I was gonna get a pizza tonight, but they don't have the right flavor. They just have this plain crust, so I think we're just gonna go with burgers instead. We're done at the grocery store. We picked up everything for burgers. We got some the lowest fat fries that we could find, and we got the lowest fat beef we could find, and now we just gotta go home and prepare this meal. The sky looks awesome in this camera. My beautiful car. All right, so we're in the kitchen after grocery shopping, and I'm preparing the meat right now. The fries are in the oven. They cook for 30 minutes. So we got 25 minutes left, so that's when we're gonna get all this stuff ready. I got 96 extra lean ground beef. I'm having 8 ounces right here, so that's gonna be right at like 50 grams of protein. I'm seasoning with salt. Let's see, I think I just put salt on it right now. And then I'm gonna season it with this bacon cheddar. And it's not baking cheddar, it's bacon. The last video I said baking cheddar, so it's bacon. So it's like you can have bacon on your burger without having the fat, extra fat as bacon. So I'm gonna have it with a little bit of garlic seasoning on top of there. That is a lot of bacon seasoning. Wow.
I noticed that.
I kind of overdid that. Crap. Hope it doesn't overwhelm it. And then I'm gonna put some chopped onions, dry chopped onions on there just to give it maybe a crunch. I didn't do this last time. So when I do burgers, you know, it has to be very low fat because my high carb days are normally pretty low in fat. I'm gonna figure all my calories and the macros later on after I get done with all this, so you will know what numbers I'm at. I already figured it all up, so let me just go ahead and tell you what I'm at. Sorry, Shelby, you're holding the camera. Right now, I am at 146 grams of protein, carbs 107, fat is only 23, and calories, where are you at? Calories is 1180. So by the end of this, I'm thinking I'll be right at maybe 2500 calories. Carbs will somewhere be 250 to 300. So we'll see in a little while after I pretty much eat all this stuff. Okay, I was looking for the bag of the French fries. So the French fries, the macros on it, you don't have to get it. What was it, 3 carbs per serving?
No.
Or carbs. 3 grams of fat per serving, and what, 18 carbs, I think?
19, I think.
19, and the whole thing was what, like 5 servings or something? So it really depends on how much I eat. But that was the lowest fat fries that we could find. Normally I would make my own fries, but because we were at the gym really late and right now it's 9 o'clock, we're just about to eat dinner. So we had to get some pre-made fries. Cooking the hamburgers here, they're just about done. The fries are in the oven for another 4 minutes. Let me show you the buns that we're using. This is the onion hamburger buns. These things are amazing. The macros on these for one is 150 calories, 2.5 grams of fat, and 28 carbs. So not that bad. I'm gonna have 2 of these. I have some fat-free cheese here. The macros on cheese, I forgot what it is. I'll add it all up later, so don't you worry. And then we have ketchup for seasoning, mustard, and where's the mayonnaise, or milk, Miracle Whip. We got the light Miracle Whip. The macros on this is only 20 calories, 1.5 grams of fat, and 2 carbs. And I think that's pretty much it. So we're just gonna put the burgers on here, put a little bit of lettuce for health on there. Dinner is ready. The fries, the delicious looking hamburgers. These things look massive. Shelby's doesn't look as big as mine.
Well, yours got a,
I got that big old
tomato.
Yeah, that tomato is massive. Ooh. Looks delicious. And then I got a Frisco. These things
that
are really
a
good. A Fresca. What did I say? Frisco?
Yeah.
Fresca. The black cherry citrus is probably my favorite diet drink right now. Really good. So we're gonna enjoy this food and watch some kind of TV. Shelby's got Judge Judy on right now, but I don't wanna watch that. Now it's on to dessert. Let me show you the ice cream that I'm having tonight. So I was gonna have Halo Top, but I can have more carbs. So what I picked up at the store, I think 2 or 3 days ago, Dreyer's, this is a limited edition peanut butter cookie dough. It's the half the fat, so the macros on this thing is for half a cup, 120 calories, 4 grams of fat, and let me see the carbs, I got my hand over it, and not and 18 grams of carbs. So the macros are pretty good. I have a bowl of it here, and then I added some cereal to it, Cinnamon Toast Crunch, and that is gonna be dessert. So I'm gonna finish watching a movie that we have over here, and then I'm gonna add up all the calories and then let y'all know what the total for the day is. All done with dessert, and the movie that we watched is over. And now just sitting down watching some TV, about to go take a shower because it is 11:30 and we need to hit the sack because I gotta get up tomorrow and do cardio, burn off all these carbs that I ate today. And then we have to do a lot tomorrow because tomorrow's our last day being here in Austin until we drive to go see family for Easter on Wednesday. So we got a lot to do tomorrow. And let me give you the macros for today. So all of today, everything I had after adding everything up, I had 2,300 calories on the dot. I have no idea how 2,300 calories on the dot even happened. I've never seen that. I've never been able to do that. And then had 211 grams of protein. Carbs had 247, and fat was 53 grams. And so tomorrow we'll start back on my low carb day. I'll probably do 2 days of low carbs. Probably not gonna do three, honestly. Three was pretty bad. So I'll probably go tomorrow and Wednesday, very low carb, and then Thursday, I'll have a high carb day again. But guys, I'm gonna end the video here. I hope you enjoyed the full day of higher carb eating. And if you did, give the video a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe, and I will see y'all next time. All right, guys, peace. Wow, you can tell how much hard work he has put in his physique, for sure. Just insane.